At this point, I'd like to bring up two key members of the many people that contributed to the tremendous success we've enjoyed over the last 6 years. These gentlemen are creators of the Craft series that's been so famous for us. I'd like to bring up the two co-presidents of Naughty Dog, Jason Rubin and Andy Gavin.
I'm Jason Rubin, and this is Andy Gavin. We're from Naughty Dog, the creators of Crash Bandicoot series. Just a small recap, it was a 22 million unit selling game worldwide, and then generated over $500 million in sales. So we did quite well in the last generation. I apologize, I'm losing my voice. It's developer hours, I've gotten a cold, and I'm about halfway there, and I'm probably gonna lose the other half in this discussion, but I could not miss. This is a huge, huge moment for Naughty Dog. Huge moment for the 33 people that worked on the title you're about to see for the last year and a half, some of them up to 2 years now we've been working on this. Without further ado, let's take a look at Jak and Daxter. Here today, but there's a lot more to it than the video gives it justice, so I'm really excited to have the first time a public look at it. We began working on Jak and Daxter character design and some of the initial programming right after Crash 3, and we used the same team that we used to create the Crash characters. By that I mean most of the Naughty Dogs that were there in the early Crash days are still there. We have many additional new talented people that have come to help us. We also work with Mark Cerny of Cerny Games, was there during the early Crash days, as well as all of our producers at Sony internationally, discussing the character, going over the character designs for a six-month period before we came up with characters we were happy with. In a lot of ways, we've matured, so I feel really, really good about the character designs and the way the game is going now. I'm going to turn this over to Andy, who's going to give you a little bit about the background and the technical specs, and I'm going to do a little run-through and a little demo.
Hello. Actually, Jason was lying a bit about the cold. It was last night's party and he's got a good voice. From the beginning, our vision on Jak and Daxter was to create a completely immersive, seamless game world with an ultra-high level of organic detail. In the Crash Bandicoot series, we created an on-rails organic world that was gorgeous with a tremendous amount of detail not seen before in video games and real-time games. And now with Jak and Daxter, we've opened this up, both visually and gameplay-wise, to create completely free-roaming, smooth, continuous roll with no load times through the entire length of the game after loading. You can walk from one end to the other. Also, in the previous generation, most objects in the world were either canned animations or kind of static. And in Jak and Daxter, we used the power of the PlayStation 2's vector units to like both animate and add real physics dynamics to like tremendous amount of objects in the world, bushes blowing in the wind, bridges you can bounce on and interact with, real rigid body physics and stuff. This immense seamless world has been created by hand by artists. It's not a height map with objects just stuck down. It's tens of millions of polygons modeled by hand in great detail. Artists turn out tens of thousands of polygons a day of like hand-modeled, handcrafted world geometry. And you can see vast extents of the world at once. Jason turned off the character and is flying around to show you that you can like cruise from, you know, one end of a vast view to another seamlessly without pop shifting. You can just kind of roll through the world from high vantage points. You can see across like hours of gameplay levels, across the distant areas that you will reach later in the game or have been. And we feel that this is the largest and most impressive, like real-time 3D world that's yet been created in games history, and it's all running live, 60 frames a second, due to the power of the PlayStation 2. And the polygons we're giving you to are no longer just simple plain polygons. They're complex, like intelligent polygons. They have dynamic lighting. You can see through this demo that the time of day shifts like slowly. Like from morning to noon and so on. Shadows creep across there's multiple light sources, flickering torches. We have an innovative level of detail system that smoothly reduces the background geometry up to 16-fold as you pull away, so that you're able to look out what's essentially miles of game distance. And in the foreground character arena, we have an IK joint base skinning system for the characters that enhances our already renowned Naughty Dog animation, like combining the talents of our many brilliant animators with the technology to get like seamless character interaction. We have vertex animation or like cool facial expressions and stuff, and tons of surface effects like environment mapping and other effects like that on large areas, like huge structures in the world. Besides the kind of obviously visual technologies, we've also invested a tremendous amount of energy in a new intelligent camera AI that uses line of sight to dynamically like keep the character in sight, reduce motion sickness, and provide like an automated and like intelligent viewpoint on the game. We have tons of individually coded advanced character AIs, obstacle avoidance, pack dynamics, gap jumping. We have a super sophisticated animation blending technology on the characters, which like speeds up our animations, creates new animations, and allows the animation of really like, we hope, like future animation quality, like sort of integrated in-game sequences. And I think the effective detail and complexity of the world is the most it's ever been seen before in a real-time game, even on $4,000 or more workstations and machines.
Sorry about the drop out there. When you fly around, you're doing things that a non-flying character can't do, so we're going under the inclusion area. We've been really excited to work on the PlayStation 2. When we were working on Crash Bandicoot 2, after doing Crash 1, we said, we've got to have a seamless world. We've got to be able to walk around, no load times. You know, it's just what we got to do, and we couldn't do it. And Crash 3 came around, and we said, we've got to do it. We spent a few months trying to do it, couldn't do it. CTR, we wanted to do it, actually, as part of the Getting Internet Erasers. Couldn't do it. PlayStation 2 came around, and a whole new world opened up to us. We're using an amount of polygons, minimum 100 times what we could do on the PlayStation one, and I mean that. It's a very specific, serious number. Often 200, 300 times as many polygons we're using in a single frame. And it's allowed us to really open up a lot of new things. The other thing is that we were shocked, as I'm sure all you were, when the new generation came and all of a sudden we had all these new capabilities, with how difficult it was to handle all of the data creation, all of the data management, all of the incredibly complex things that come along with worlds this big and that much stuff that we're putting in these games. And I think not the hardware difficulty specifically, but simply being forced into a new generation is such a leap that's created for us a little bit of a learning curve. And we're now coming out of that learning curve. And I think you're going to see the other games you'll see today around the show. It's now, we're in our stride. We'll be sharing the technology on this game with a few developers. Certainly within large publishers, technologies will be shared. We're over the hump, and at this point, it's your imagination that's going to determine how good your game is, and no longer how difficult it might have been to get over the generational gap. So I'm really excited for the PlayStation 2. I absolutely have no doubt that it's going to be the system. That was what drove Naughty Dog to join with a publisher of 5 years in an incredible relationship. We're now a wholly owned subsidiary of Sony because we knew we were going to be on the PlayStation 2 throughout this entire generation. I thank you. I appreciate your time, and definitely check the game out at the booth. Thank you very much.